Hi everybody, good morning, this is DJ Joe Redhead, and as usual I'm starting with my shades on, because if you don't know I'm cool, why are you gonna watch the rest of this? Now isn't that better? It's actually Pride weekend, which means all the bars have a cover of like $55 and it's packed, like everywhere you go is packed. It's kind of amateur hour, kind of like St. Patrick's Day and New Year's Eve. There are too many people, and you're like, oh god, oh my god, ah! Too many gays. But it is exciting, and I'm really looking forward to seeing the parade, because I love a parade. And of course, we're on the heels of a big milestone in New York State, which is gay marriage becoming legal. Which I don't have anything funny to say about, because it's about time. I've actually had a really, really diverse 2 weeks. And part of that was going to WWE Raw on Long Island. My boyfriend loves his wrestling. It was something he watched with his younger brother when they were growing up. I think it's one of those things that got you at the right age. For example, for me, it was Pokemon. So we decided to go together. And I have to say that this is a fascinating world. I liked it a little bit, partly because the guys are hot. Do we have a picture of the guys? Yeah. Nice. John Cena is their hero. And so what ends up happening is you get these like crowd call and response things where it's like, let's go Cena. But then at the same time, there are people on the other side who don't like John Cena. So they're over here shouting, Cena sucks. But then what was really funny is I swear to God, I looked around that crowd and I saw people chanting both sections. Like let's go Cena, Cena sucks. Like just like right across the board, because these are people that want someone to be fighting someone else or themselves. That's all I want to see. What they do not want to see is theater, for example, because at one point the WWE Babes came out and did a tribute to Broadway. One of the lead girls, I think her name is Kelly Kelly, got on the mic and said, hey everybody, last night in New York City was the Tony Awards. There's no noise at all. And these are people that scream for nothing, like scream when the ring is empty. I don't even think that they were, like, passing judgment on the Tony Awards. I think that they were just confused about what that even was. You know what else is scary? Computer overlords. 3 times in the last 2 days, someone has talked about technology outpacing humanity. Or I have heard something about technology outpacing humanity. And it is creepy every time. And of course we're there already, because that computer won Jeopardy. Which, did anyone watch that? That was really scary to me. The one cool thing about it, though, is that at the bottom of the screen, it would show you the 3 different like runner-up guesses that it had. And what's funny is because it's just pulling keywords from what Alex Trebek says, sometimes they'd be very wrong. Like, the answers along the bottom would be like Sistine Chapel. Or maybe it got it right with Sistine Chapel, but then its second guess was going to be milk. Also interesting is figuring out how we think, and I just stumbled across one of my favorite things in the world, which is the Turing tests. This is an event that honors British mathematician Alan Turing. So the Turing test is there to determine if a computer can communicate as well as a human being can. Here's what it is. One man sits, or woman, this is 2011, man or woman sits in a booth, and they're having an instant message chat conversation with either a machine or another person, and they have to determine which is which. There's an award given to people who are better at determining if they're talking to a real person, and this is what I really like, there's an award for the person who is the most human, that if the contestant's guessing always figure out that you're human, you receive an award called the Most Human Human Award. I would love to go do this. Doesn't that sound like fun? The question is, what's going to happen when computers are better at us at communicating? Because that's always been a thing that I felt like we were going to have over technology, is this sort of like communicative rhetorical sensitivity. But think, pretty soon, like are they going to be funnier than we are? This megabytes... I don't want there to be computer comedians, but imagine if there's some like algorithm, the computer has it, it's on TV telling jokes, and we just can't stop laughing. Like, there's a strange sort of limitlessness when it comes to machine thought. So like, imagine like the funny, like the hardest you've ever laughed, like the best sex you've ever had. Like, are these all coming with computers? I hate it so much. I don't want to think about these sorts of things because they freak me out. Anyway, so today's Pride. I'm going to hit the gym and then I am going to go to a Cowboys and Indians party. Didn't know this still happened. Have a good weekend, everybody. If you're in New York, congratulations on the Senate passing that historic bill. And if you're not in New York, get your state on it. Unless you're in the states that have already done it ahead of us. I love you all, and I'll talk to you all soon. Bye-bye. It's a little bit scary when you're sitting there, and all I'm trying to do is eat my box meal. Like, all I do is eat at, like, basically any sporting event I ever attend. And, yeah! Oh, God. My fries.